Hey, so I told you guys I had one more guest for our Awesome Dudes Chat, brought to you by Refresh, my lifestyle brand. As we celebrate Men's Health and National Men's Health Month, so I certainly hope that you guys have enjoyed the conversation so far. Thank you so much to some amazing gentlemen, huh? Oh my goodness, Leslie Jordan, Boris Kodjo, and New York Times bestselling author Brad Thor. Wow. Just was great. I'm so excited. So closing out tonight's conversation, or this afternoon's conversation, is a gentleman that I actually work with on my new series, The Upshaws, for Netflix. He is fantastic. Super, super cool guy. He's an actor. He's a model, a fitness guru. And so I'm really excited to share his story and his work with you guys, and not just in terms of us working together and how hilarious he is, but he's really inspirational in terms of fitness, and he's been doing a lot during quarantine to be able to share with you guys. Somebody said, Jermelle! Yes, here he comes. Let's go, Jermelle. Okay, let me get him in the room. My goodness, everybody's only wanting to see Jermelle. Let me get out of here. Hold on. Here he comes. You better have your shirt on, boy.
Can you see me?
I can, but your head is cut off. Why are you trying to show too much of your chest?
No, son? See, that was what I was trying to avoid, Kim.
Yeah, sure.
That was a part of the agreement. So I put on a nice little shirt for you and everything. Kim Fields, how you doing?
What up? Now, many of you are going, wait, how is he playing her son? Yeah, exactly. So.
With the beard, I can play your brother right now. But normally I have a little shadow. So it's a little different, right?
Yeah, so he doesn't look quite as, you know, his age as he does right now. He plays younger, okay? That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. But team mom. without giving any of the storyline away.
Right.
We don't want Netflix to cut our feed.
Right, done.
So, dude, during quarantine, I know that you, me, and our dear brother, Paige Kennedy, we have been... You're cutting up already. So our dear friend and brother and coworker, Paige Kennedy. So we have this phenomenal thread, the three of us, where we try to encourage each other. We make each other laugh. We keep each other posted. And Jermelle has been really great to keep us inspired in terms of, you know, nutrition and working out during the quarantine so that, you know, when we do get to go back to work, it ain't like, oh God, we got to buy a new wardrobe. But aside from that, but just being able to really understand, you know, just the importance of taking care. And many of the gentlemen, if you've been able to watch tonight, have been able to talk about, you know, especially whether you're male or female, but just that whole sense of this is on you, your health and wellness and well-being. So how has this journey been for you in terms of health and wellness, especially for a generation who you guys usually don't care as much because you feel immortal and you feel, you know, that sense of youth and just, I don't need to do that.
Well, I first started working out just, if I'm honest, just to feel macho and feel, you know, supreme, boosting my ego a little bit. And then I realized me working out actually made me feel better. Like I internally felt good. And it made me happy. So I just kind of connected the two. And I went on this pursuit of happiness or whatever. And I started reading a lot of books. And I realized so much how beneficial working out really is versus just, because my idea was I just wanted to be shirtless, you know, as most men might do in the beginning. But I realized it boosts my endorphins. I have better skin, just from my heart constantly pumping, pretty much, you know, doing a lot of cardio. And then I just kind of got addicted to it. And so for me, I do it more so just for my mental health, for my happiness. I feel like it all connects.
Yeah. Can you, and thank you for that sense of transparency, you know, in terms of how you got started and what your journey has been. But for you, in terms of it having an effect on your, I will not ask this man to take his shirt off.
What's the name?
Lena 90221. Yes, no. Yes. Yeah, you can unbutton one button and make her happy. That's it. That's it.
I did one button for you, Kim. One button, no.
So stupid. But in terms of your mental, the mental benefits, you mm-hmm. know, can you talk about that in turn and how it connects with health and wellness, especially from the male perspective?
I just feel like it boosts, you know, your endorphins, which at the end of the day is what you need, you know, mm-hmm. for your happiness. And I feel like for me, that was the major reason why I did it. Mm-hmm. Just for that, as far as it's just with, you know, heart disease being the number one killer in amongst African Americans, that was another thing. I have a couple of those issues running in my family, and I read up on just how cardio, just every day, even if it's 10, 15 minutes, is so mm-hmm. beneficial for your heart. Which again is the number one killer. I think a lot of people don't understand that. Just heart disease. You can simply work out 5 to 10 minutes and mm-hmm. that brings your percentage of getting it so low. So I think it was that I got really serious about my health and the benefits of it. So with my endorphins, I'm happy, I'm healthy. Mm-hmm. I can't really ask for anything else other than that.
Yeah. With Father's Day coming up, and happy early Father's Day.
Thank you.
For you, do you have a sense, and I asked this of Boris as well, and you kind of touched on it in terms of, you know, just generationally and being aware of what is a part of your family's, you know, medical history.
Right.
And that's something that we I think take for granted. So I'm just messing with you, Lena. I'm just messing with you. But that's something that I think we take for granted because we either look at our most immediate circle, like, oh, she's good, he's good, they're good, you know, and that's it. But in terms of generational health and wellness, does that play into your motivation at all? For example, because you do have little ones and wanting to be an example?
For sure, most definitely. Because I grew up on fried chicken, collard greens, and I grew up in Florence, South Carolina. So I'm from the South, and that was all I knew. But I also knew how that food made me feel. And mm-hmm. I just recently went pescatarian, which meaning I eat fish only. But I realized how sluggish and just it was, how toxic that was, you know, for my body. Again, every now and then I go back home and have me, you know, a piece of chicken or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Once I connected that you are what you eat, I told myself I can't, with my children, I really can't. Me having that, you know better, you do better.
Yeah.
And so I try to raise them the best of my ability to, you know, eat as healthy as possible. Just because I know it all connects to your happiness as well. Like sugar has something that suppresses the I don't know what the name of it is, but pretty much sugar suppresses your happiness. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people don't understand that, especially sugar, candy sugar, you know what
uh-huh.
I mean?
Uh-huh.
And so when I realized that, I try to use what I know and, of course, give it to my kids. My son still loves McDonald's. I'm guilty. I sometimes still give him McDonald's.
Yeah.
But I try to teach them, you know, you are what you eat. That's the simplest thing. You are what you eat.
Mm-hmm.
I can go out and I can have, you know, macaroni and cheese and all this starch and all this. And the next morning I want to feel better.
Yeah.
And I think I had to start taking accountability for that. Well, it was what I grew up on.
Sure.
It's not good for me.
Yeah.
It's good.
Well, everything in for me. Right. And everything in moderation. Like you said, occasionally you'll go home and you'll have some, that sort of thing. But everything in moderation. But, you know, the idea of longevity. You know, Paige is in the room. Paige is in the room, and Paige says he's eating popcorn.
Exactly.
Hi, Paige Kennedy.
Paige, can you leave the room, please?
Never.
That was a part of the agreement for you not to be here.
So, guys, Paige Kennedy is also in the series. He plays Mike Epps' best friend. I play Mike Epps' wife. Jermelle plays me and my son. That's all. That's all we can tell you. That's all we can tell you. In terms of longevity, you know, and Brad Thor, the author that we were speaking with right before IG ended. Yeah, oh my gosh, you'll love him. Yeah. And you've seen it on set too, the one that I had on set.
Yeah, it was really a nice thing.
Yeah. But with longevity, how important is it to think about that for your generation, for this generation right now? You know, because again, there's a tendency that, you know, not really looking past tomorrow.
Right. I think for me, I have a different outlook on it because I have children and I want to live to be 200. Probably won't happen, but, you know, I just think what we do now affects everything, you know, what affects later. So for me, I've been taking a lot of vitamins. I've been doing anything proactive, you know, like I said, doing a lot of cardio for my heart because I won't be 31 forever. I won't have the same heart. I won't have the same, you know, organs, and everything is going to kind of do a wear and tear. So if I can prolong that by eating something different, by going the extra mile on my treadmill, on my bike, doing HIIT classes, whatever I need to do to, you know, have longevity in this thing called life, I'm going to do. And I know the ways to get there as far as, again, my blood pumping, I'm staying active, and just eating right. So I think it plays a big role. It's the reason why I'm able to play your son and still be this age. I was trying to tread light, and you were like, what?
It was about
to be Thug Mama K in a minute. But no, I...
Everybody don't know about Thug Lady K.
I forgot about that one.
So in closing, and thank you, everybody, for jumping back on. To finish out Refresh by KF, our inaugural, our launch pad for Amazing Dudes Chat, and especially as we celebrate and honor men's health and talking about men's health during National Men's Health. What kind of advice do you give? You know, I know that you've got your fitness classes that are, you guys can join a class, right?
Right. Right now, I'm doing Zoom classes, so Mondays and Wednesdays, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time and Pacific Time. I do this thing that I created called JRambo HIIT, and pretty much it's like a dance, hip-hop, Zumba-type class. You pretty much squat to the beat. Kim, we got to get you in there. And so my biggest thing is I realized that people don't come back to classes because they're not having fun. So a lot of people don't realize enjoyment is a big part of consistency. So if you're not enjoying it, you're not going to come back. So I try to create an environment where people actually like it. I have a lot of energies. I have this thing. I do mental checks. So I say, how we feeling? You say, amazing. And we say that 9,000 times.
Okay.
So just mental checks and just making it fun, you know, constantly motivating. As you know, I like to talk. So I talk the entire 45 minutes.
Wow.
Distracting people, you know, what they're doing. And really adding good music and just all that good time. Make it like a workout party.
Yeah. So awesome. Awesome. Well, there's a lot of people saying that they have been to your Zoom classes. They love it, that you're amazing. Paige even said that your classes are lit. Paige will never pay Jermelle a compliment. So
never.
That's,
so that's
major.
I was like, oh, take, I wanted something.
Take a screenshot of that.
Jennifer, thank you. And my app will be out. It's called JRambo HIIT. It will be out July 15th. So it's motivation there. We got abs, lower body workouts. I was going to say booty. I already said it now. Booty workout, anything you need, we got it on the app. So it's July 15th.
Got you. All right. And we will have information on Jermelle's classes, the app. We will update you guys on that so that we can feature it at Refresh. Our Instagram is at Refresh by KF, Refresh by KF. So we'll have all of his info there, how you guys can join. Someone said follow JRambo HIIT Facebook. Okay.
Thank you, Ashley.
And July 15th, his app drops. So thank you so much. It's been
thank
great having
so much,
a really great cross-section in terms of gender. Well, not gender, you're all male. But in terms of generation, in terms of race, So, you know, we really appreciate just kind of the cross-section of gentlemen that have been a part of today's awesome dude chat. So thank you very much.
Thank you for having
much.
Me, Kim.
Of course.
Thank you for considering me.
Of course. Absolutely. Absolutely. So any parting words to your fellow man out there watching and looking at, okay, how do I get myself going or stay or do something that is sustainable for me in my life right now?
I think that Boris touched on this too, just taking baby steps bit by bit. I think most importantly for me is just being nice to yourself. Some days you just don't feel like doing it. You know, you just do the best you can. And mm-hmm. The best you can differ from Monday and Tuesday. But as long as you're giving it the best you can, as long as you're moving, you're winning, and just being nice to yourself. If you're gonna mm-hmm. if you're gonna get there regardless, you might as well have fun with it. So keep pushing mm-hmm. it, taking it day by day. Eventually you're gonna reach the top. Just being nicer to yourself on this journey, because it's like you said, it's a lifestyle. It's not something that I'm gonna stop tomorrow. If I'm gonna do this till I'm in the grave, mm-hmm. I might as well just have fun with it. So just mm-hmm. not taking it so serious, just doing the best you can each and every day, and you'll realize over time your best grows more and more. So
Paige said take your shirt off.
Paige, take your shirt off.
It is off. We know Paige so
right.
well. Brother, thank you so much.
Thank
and
you
I appreciate
so much.
You.
Love you.
Love you too, brother. Thank you so much. All right. So, guys, we are finishing up today's chat. Next Saturday at 4 o'clock Eastern, 1 o'clock Pacific, we have a whole new set of gentlemen for our amazing dudes chat. It's epic. That's all I can tell you. It is epic. And just another wonderful cross section in terms of generations, in terms of races, in terms of celebrity, life experiences, all of that. So we will finish up next Saturday talking about men's health and celebrating National Men's Health right here next Saturday at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 o'clock Pacific. I know somebody said the bugs are getting me. I know. I don't know where my citronella is up above. But anyway, have a wonderful Father's Day weekend. Gentlemen, I sincerely hope that you enjoyed these chats. I sincerely hope that you got something out of them to inspire you, to sustain what you're doing, to jumpstart what you might want to do, and to remember that you are valued, you are loved, you are treasured. You are so worth everything, even if the world says otherwise. There is a place where we think and know that you are so valuable and so treasured, and we want you to take care of you, and we will do our best to take care of you and provide you with a sanctuary and a place full of inspiration and information and encouragement and light and laughter and joy and all sorts of other things. So I hope that you sincerely enjoyed this. Thank you, everybody. Ladies, thank you for your support of this. Do what you can. You know, for you ladies who were in the room today and you were able to hear information, maybe share with some of the men in your circle, in your village, okay? Have a great, great Saturday. Happy Father's Day to you all. Mwah!